Hood and Duke.
It starts right here, just as a thought. And then that thought travels all the way down here. Hawaiians call this place your na'au. It's a place where all of your emotions sit. And it's right here, right in your na'au, that thought grabs onto something. Something good. Something that is the best of who you are. Just a tiny piece of it. And then that tiny piece of goodness quickly makes its way up and out into the world. Aloha. And if you're lucky, it will cause the same reaction in those around you. And before you know it, something amazing has happened. Something that has the power to change the world. My name is Duke, and I'd like to share my story with you. It's a story of aloha. The year is 1894.
Hawaiian kings were really good at speaking it, so they named it after them. But then, if that's true, I think they're gonna have to go back to calling it just regular English again, because all of our kings died, and the queen, well, she's not the queen anymore. I don't really know why, but that's what my makua told me. Anyway, Papa and I are in Kalia. It's a place in Waikiki, and it's where we live. Right now, he and I are doing one of my favorite things. Paddling in his ba'a. Well, Papa's paddling. I'm just pretending. I'm only four. We usually paddle out to do some fishing, but I don't see any spears, no nets, not even any hooks. I think I'll ask him. Ipa'a, he'ahaka kawahana, aihena mi'alawe'a. Ipa'a, Papa. Why are you looking at me like that?
Oh no, Papa's smiling. It's his Koloe smile. His I'm about to do something that you probably won't like smile. Wait a minute. I'm 4. Papa told me what his father did to him when he was 4, but I didn't believe him.
Hey, Papa, hey, Hakohana.
He said his father put him in his ba'a and paddled him way out. No, Papa, please. And just when he least expected it, Papa, don't. I'm only 4. He tossed him into the sea. Papa! Into that water. I was so angry at him, I splashed, kicked and tossed about in a furious panic, unable to see anything but flashes of sunlight and deep darkness. But then, all of a sudden, everything stopped. The panic stopped. My anger disappeared, and a single thought came into my mind. My father, the very one who threw me into the water. I turned around. There he was, smiling at me. It wasn't his Kolohe smile. It was a smile that told me that everything was going to be okay. And as I moved towards him, I realized that I was swimming.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Stockholm, Sweden for the 1912 Olympic Games. 20 countries send their best to compete in hopes of bringing home the coveted gold medal. Athletes from Belgium, Portugal, China, Japan, Denmark, Egypt.
And me, wearing the banner of the United States on my chest and the flag of Hawaii in my na'au, my island of home. No more than 8 tiny dots on a map. I would be surprised if no one here had ever even heard of Hawaii. Well, after these games, they'll know.
My fingertips break the surface of the water. My outstretched arms follow, then my head, my chest, my legs, my feet. I am submerged. The feeling is familiar, though my body has never known these waters. Above me is a ripple on the surface. It grows. It spreads to the end of the pool, but doesn't stop. It travels through lakes, ponds, seas, and over oceans. It reaches Hawaii. And touches the shores of Kalia.
Duke Kahanamoku is a swimmer the likes of which the world has never seen.
There are fish there. My brothers are there. My sisters. My parents. My family. My people.
Duke Kahanamoku has made quite a splash.
Every stroke of my arm is powered by their strength. Every kick of my leg is the push of an ancestor. Eya Hawaii.
Olympic Games and was invited to swimming meets and exhibitions all over the globe. But whenever I could, I always made it a point to share the art of surfing
with whoever wanted to learn. They say that over 70% of the Earth is covered by water. When you think about it, that's a lot of waves hitting a lot of shorelines. So it's hard to believe that in the history of the world, no one ever thought to make a connection with the harmony of a wave. No one but Hawaiians, that is. Today, people love to call me the father of surfing. I think that's silly. It was my own father that taught me to surf, Duke Paoa Kahanamoku. That's who I'm named after. A wonderful man. Kahanamoku is our family name. It means to work the land, which might sound a bit ironic, being that most of what I'm known for took place in the water. But with Hawaiians, it's all connected. The land, the sea, the sky, beyond. Take surfing, for example. When my father taught me to surf, the first thing he said to me was, "You're gonna need a board." But then he asked me if I knew where that board would come from. I thought about it, and then I said, "The forest." You see, the old Hawaiians carved their boards out of wood gifted to them by the trees of the uplands. When my father and I shaped our boards, we'd hew them with tools called ko'o. We'd work for hours until it was just the right form and length. Some of our boards were 16 feet long or more. When the shape was just right, we'd then smooth it out. We never had any calipers to measure the thickness of the wood, so we used our hands and went by feel. When the work was done, the board was carried to the beach, where the ancient friendship between the trees of the uplands and the waters of the sea were remembered in a magnificent dance. I couldn't have been happier to be the one to share that dance with the rest of the world. Newport Beach, Long Island, Huntington Beach, Atlantic City, New Zealand, and of course, Freshwater Beach in Sydney, Australia.
I've never seen anything like it! We were all gathered at the beach, looking at the lights, because someone said there'd be some sort of fancy demonstration. And before we knew what was happening, a big brown guy came riding on a tree! I've never seen anything like it! And if I recall correctly, the big brown guy ended his demonstration by jumping off of his tree and wrestling a shark!
I said to myself, now there's a sport I could do. On January 27th, 1968, a crowd gathered on the sands near Kalia. Someone started to sing the song Aloha Oe. It's a song of love, a song of farewell. Others joined in as a canoe was launched into the water. And as the crowd watched, my ashes were returned to the sea.